Dating's fun, isn't it? With apps and things and people, and there's so many ways to meet people and cheat on people. There's lots of ways to cheat on people. I was with somebody for 3.5 years. 2.5 of those years, he was fucking people he met on AshleyMadison.com. Thank you for the applause. It was fantastic. It was a nightmare. You know, it's funny because he was fucking somebody named Dark Chocolate, and I was like, I didn't even know he liked candy. What's happening? It was so awful. But, you know, hindsight's 20/20. Like, our relationship was weird. There were a lot of red flags. Red flag number one, he would only have sex with me in the missionary position. Yes. Never mowed my box. Yes. Drove a Scion. Hey. Like, if you're gonna fuck me over, come with a Tesla, honey. Like, you know what I mean? So I can just be like, well, but he drove a really nice car, you guys. It was just awful. And I remember, you know, thinking about our relationship, and I was like, now it's all coming together. Like, you know, whenever I asked for our sex to be more exciting, you know, I'm like, why can't we have more exciting sex? He would look me right in the face and say, Sharon, I want sex to be pure and innocent with you because too many women have controlled me with sex. Exactly. Say it to yourself in the mirror without laughing. That cannot be done. Okay, we all want to be controlled by sex. I want to be controlled by sex. I want some guy to fuck me so good that I stop talking to my parents. I lose my job. My car gets repossessed. I'm homeless. My friends are like, what's wrong with you? I'm like, this guy is fucking me so good. Just lose my fucking mind. And you know why I would end the relationship? Because I was no longer being controlled by sex. That's the fucking goal. And I saw pictures of the women he was fucking from the internet, and they looked very controlling, like they could control forklifts, bulldozers, teams of Clydesdales. They were very strong. He definitely had a type. And here's what's even more embarrassing. More embarrassing than dating somebody who was cheating on you with weirdos he met on the internet, he was a retired pop locker. He retired from popping and locking, y'all. Who does that? What do? You just go, that's it. I'm retired. I'm throwing out my beret and my bandanas. Get rid of the cardboard. No more. Don't play Kraftwerk because I will not dance to it. I am retired. I mean, that's just... I remember I would like play Zap in LA Dream Team to try to get him to do something. He would never dance for me. It was very frustrating. It was. But here's the good news. The good news is that after that, you know, I didn't get mad. I actually was kind of like, when the relationship ended, I was like, that's it. It's over. I'm moving on. I didn't get angry until I went to the gynecologist to get tested for STDs. And I went and I got the results back. And it turns out the only thing I tested positive for was game. Hey, what? Hey, hey. That's right. Tested positive for game. All the men came to the yard. Let me tell you something.